Studies on human embryonic stem cells are highly controversial, and the current law says that embryos must be destroyed after 14 days. But why 14 days? What's so significant about a 2-week limit? And should we even keep using it? Hi there, my science buddies. Julian here for DNews. Human embryonic stem cells are one of the most legally and morally contentious areas of study. On the one hand, stem cells, both adult and embryonic, are valuable for researching a huge range of illnesses and diseases, from cancer to diabetes to Alzheimer's. On the other hand, many people believe that this benefit to medicine comes at the cost of potential human lives. If you want a bit of background on the moral and medical controversies surrounding stem cells, you can check out either of these videos on the screen. Originally, the 14-day limit comes from a 1979 United States Department of Health, Education, and Welfare report. A committee of theologians, psychologists, and doctors came to a compromise. Human embryonic stem cells could be studied for 2 weeks after fertilization, beyond which time the cells would have to be destroyed. But this limit was fairly arbitrary, as at the time, scientists could not keep embryos alive in vitro for more than a few days. A later report, organized in 1984 by British existential philosopher Mary Wernick, justified the 2-week limit. The report states that on the 14th or 15th day, a faint line of cells appears on the embryo, called the primitive streak. This, it was argued, is a moment that signifies that the embryo has become an individual being, as before this time, the embryo could potentially split into twin organisms. One of the reasons this stage appealed to those who objected on moral grounds was that if an embryo could split into two people, then it could not yet be an individual person. The rule codifies an easy-to-measure mark, coupled with an unambiguous time frame, making the question less about conception or a soul, while still allowing for a religious and moral compromise. Additionally, a 2002 report from California stated that less than half of all fertilized embryos, both in vitro and in vivo, ever reached the primitive streak, meaning that most of embryos used for research would have been unlikely to make it to term anyway. But recent advances have made it possible for scientists to keep embryos alive for longer than 2 weeks by stimulating womb-like conditions. I guess they keep them at womb temperature. With the potential for further research using stem cells, the question has been forced again. Is the 14-day limit still valid? Some scientists say no, arguing that they could use the research in preventing miscarriages, infertility, and birth defects, which they believe to be more important than a more or less arbitrary time limit. For example, in 2014, researchers were able to cure induced Parkinson's disease in rats. Neuroscientists use human embryonic stem cells to create neurons that produce dopamine, which is missing in those who suffer from the disease. Although no human clinical trials have been done, these early results with animals have been very promising. That said, other researchers in bioethics have pointed out that even an arbitrary limit is better than no limit at all. As more restrictions are lifted, the very real question becomes, where's the limit on human experimentation in the pursuit of knowledge? Stem cells from human embryos may be controversial, but we've actually figured out a workaround and a way to generate stem cells that aren't controversial at all. You can hear about it in the very first episode I ever did for DNews. Check it out right here. In the United States, an average of 79 people receive an organ transplant every day, but another 18 people die waiting for a transplant that'll never come. The 79 who do get a donor will have to take medication to prevent transplant rejection for the rest of their lives, but even then, the risk remains. So what's your stance on stem cells? Awesome or not so awesome? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.